Massive fish killings at Fujian Farms is causing a stir on the tilapia market. What do authorities make of this, and what are they doing to curtail the situation? Join me on News Connect as we speak to some officials of the Fisheries Commission. My name is Kojo Ajman. Stay tuned.
Last week, Sunday, we had information that there are some fish mortalities here at Fujian Farm. So on Monday, I detailed the fish health unit. Two of our doctors, Dr. Zida and then Dr. Shandoff, with some staff to this place. And in fact, the report that they brought was that, yes, they had come to witness high mortality of tilapia, closing into about 19,000 tons. And so I gave directive that they should pick fish samples, both the dead and live tilapia, also water samples for scientific analysis. Also, we should ensure that the dead tilapia are buried. Either they are incinerated or buried under our close supervision. And also gave a directive that the company should cease production and then sale until we have gotten the findings, research findings, to inform us as to exactly what had been the cause of that high mortality rate. So today is a follow-up. It's exactly a week that the team came, and we are followed up today to find out what is happening, to collect further samples for further scientific analysis. The first samples that we dispatched some to UK, some to Singapore, France, and other places, and even local, we also have.
But don't we have the capacity to do it on our own?
No, we have capacity to do in Ghana, but it's always better to have about three, four, five opinion. And then if you are making a decision, then it will be an informed decision. So that's exactly what we are doing. And also, I've always said that crisis prevention is better than crisis management. Whatever we are witnessing today is something that we are going to, is going to inform us and a future regulatory activity so far as fish farming is concerned.
I saw you take samples of the fish.
The importance of disease monitoring is so that we are sure that if it is a disease outbreak, we can first of all only find out after analysis, but if it is a disease outbreak, it is always important to monitor and see if there's any alternations, if there's any new disease coming in the field. Now, we are part of the ICTO group from France, and we have registered the Tilavac vaccine, which we took streptococcus, a disease that was a problem a few years ago, and we developed an autogenous vaccine just to help the farmers doing so. And without monitoring other farms, we cannot develop the right vaccine on time. It takes time. So it's always important, if there's any events happening like this, it's crucial to screen.
You have observed things ongoing here. When you bring up the world standards, do you think that this farm is having safe practices or standards that you say is up to what is internationally accepted?
I believe that there's a few flaws on this farm. Just the congregations of these cages all together, they might give a big issue of water exchange. I believe that with the intensification of tilapia, the rate of any outbreaks or any environmental issues such as low oxygen or even accumulation of feed to the bottom or feces to the bottom with an upwelling event can occur with poisoning to the fishes. Yes, in the world standards, they are very spread alike. They have an environmental impact assessment for the site just to make sure that it's the right place to do the farming.
So, Doc, let me come to you. What are the crisis management plan that you have put in place for this facility?
In the first place, every farm like this one is supposed to have a fish health management plan. So we inspect and approve the fish health management plan. If there is anything untoward, like it is now, they report directly to us,
mm-hmm. which they have,
and to the local fisheries officer first, to us, and then we come in from the national this thing to see and make sure everything is going on all right.
So how are you making sure that things go on all right?
Like my director said, first, it is a serious issue. We placed quarantine on the facility. No fish comes in, no fish goes out. Production is at the barest minimum, if there's anything at all. And then we make sure of safe burial of the fish. In this case, you are talking of 20 tons and over. It is difficult to incinerate. Mm. So burial is what we are doing now. So safe burial of the fish. We make sure that nothing spreads out of this vicinity.
Is that safe? Because when I came here on Friday, I saw some fishmongers take some of the dead tilapia, and then the report I had was that they were going to process it at Salted Fish. That's what locally is known as Kobe. And you know how people like this delicacy. So let me find out from you, beyond the management crisis that you have put in place here, what are you doing to check on the markets so that we don't get any tilapia from this farm processed as Salted Fish onto the farm?
Right, thank you very
much. To the market.
I must say that, as I indicated, we got the information on Sunday at night. Monday, we took the necessary measures. Insofar as coming in is concerned, we can assure the members of the public that no dead tilapia from this farm has leaked into the mainstream. And I can say that some are not gone out before our arrival. But our post-harvest unit are also there. We directed them to be in league with the National Fish Processors Association to link up with their membership and also to spread the message to the market. So that in the unlikely event that some may have filtered out there, at least there is a way of detecting that, so that those who are actually adhering to strict healthy practices will not be affected as far as marketing of their produce is concerned.
Should we be scared as Ghanaians consuming tilapia because of this case?
No, I do not believe that. Unless you are eating dead tilapia, I've never really tried the Kobe, like you've mentioned it, so I cannot really speculate on that. But I wouldn't really eat any dead tilapia. And it's a pity to hear such a thing, because you have such a beautiful product here in this country. Mm. And a lot of farmers are working hard to make sure that you have this fish on your table. So keep it fresh and don't eat the salted dead tilapia if you can. That's my recommendation.
What is the future of fish farming in the country with regards to some of these indicators that we're having on the ground?
I think the future is very bright if we can manage our biosecurity very well. Without biosecurity, everything is going to just go haywire.
We will be monitoring events at Fujian Farms and we'll keep you posted. That'll be all for this episode of News Connect on City TV. My name is Kojo Ajman. Let's connect soon.